Hallelujah. We just want to let you meet the minister for this morning. The person God is sending our way today is not new to most of us who are here. Evangelist Segun Ehimison and his wife Bose are in the house. Amen. Amen. Evangelist Ehimison actually is Foursquare Sokoro member sent out to go and do all the things he's doing until he comes once in a while to give us a report and a feel of how God is using him. Amen. He has been with us since yesterday again as we started the divine visitation, and the Lord, in fact, since Friday, and the Lord will be, through his evangelistic ministry, his outreach ministry, blessing and speaking to us in the service this morning. God bless you.
I believe you can do better. Let's put our hands together unto the Lord. Hallelujah. Church, praise the Lord. We are in missions month. And the question is, how involved are you? How totally are you sold out into winning souls for the Lord? The Bible records in Matthew chapter 9, verses 37 and 38. It said, Jesus says to his disciples, the harvest is truly plenteous, but the laborers are few. Pray ye therefore the Lord of harvest that he will bring in laborers into his fields. Are you ready to be one? And a songwriter says, my life is available for you. Is your life is available? Be a volunteer for Jesus. Be seated and be blessed. A volunteer for Jesus, a soldier true. All that have enlisted, why not you? Amen.
A volunteer for Jesus, a soldier true. Others have enlisted, why not you? Jesus is the captain, he never fear. Will you be enlisted as a
God.
done for mankind.
Now, just now, he calls you, causing a sense glare.
Will you be enlisted as a volunteer? A volunteer for Jesus, a soldier true. Others have enlisted, why not you? Jesus is the captain, we will never be. Will you be enlisted as a volunteer?
Change story for them. If you believe you are the one he will change story for better for, shout the loudest hallelujah. Strange indeed when an evangelist is to speak about mission, but don't worry, we'll do it by the Holy Spirit. Before I continue, can you, those of you who were here yesterday with your covenant seat, can you come and drop it on the altar under just 2 minutes and so we can continue. Those of you who were here yesterday, Tuesday is the last day by what the Spirit says to us. So, but if you're here now, please drop it on the altar drop it on the altar of the Almighty God. And everybody be ready for something. There's going to be an explosion. God bless you. Drop it on the altar. The covenant seed of yesterday, just drop it on the altar for the Almighty God. Those of you who were here yesterday, your covenant seed, you know what we talk about. Thank you. Just drop it on the altar. Drop your check. Drop your covenant seed on the altar. Those of you who were here yesterday. The rest of you, by Tuesday, you must fulfill it. It's a covenant between you and God. Nobody forces you to. It's you and your God. Thank you. Please, if you come and do it under a few minutes. Under a few minutes. Thank you. Just drop it on the altar. God bless you. Hallelujah. Thank you. Just drop it on the altar. It's a covenant seed between you and God. Thank you. Thank you. Hallelujah. Okay, are we through with that now? Those of you who are sitting down, I guess you are not part of us. Because there is time for everything. Hello. 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 I want you to hear this word. We are still in the season of divine visitation. Coming with mission. And I'd like you to understand, you're going to permit me because I am loaded to bless this money. When Jesus finished his own fasting, even though mine was not as long as that of Jesus, the next thing that happened was there were miracles. Yesterday, we had time, and I believe it's a season for me to say things to the life of people that must come. Listen to me, it does not matter what the enemy is saying about you. Everything we will say this morning shall become a testimony in your life. Your amen is dragging me back. Please, do this amen with everything in you. It's just for a few minutes. With everything in you, just for a few minutes. Everything I say, I am sent to say to somebody this morning, by the authority that cannot fail, every long-term impossibility, there is a testimony in the name of Jesus Christ. That I've held you bound for many years. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, for He has anointed me. He has anointed me this morning to say something to somebody's destiny. Every power that I've held you bound for many years, by the authority of the Most High God, I loose you in the name of Jesus Christ. I didn't hear confirm. I will preach the sermon as the Lord has given it to me. But I want you to be blessed more than your imagination. We serve a living God. And one of the proof that we serve Him is testimony. Hello. One of the proof that we serve a living God is what? Testimony. Father, every man, every woman who has been in this house from January till now that have not gotten a testimony, if their amen are confirmed, can be the loudest. The testimony that fits their life. Testimony that fits their destiny. If I can hear the loudest amen and confirm, receive it in the name of Jesus Christ. Help me go to somebody, tell the person, I will testify before you. Come on, say to another person, I will testify before you. Thank you, Jesus. Abba, Father. Abba, Father. I hear Him saying to me, this is what I hear. He says, son, say to somebody who have lost glory. The person have lost glory. But the Lord says, say to that person, I'm restoring your glory in double. I hear you, Lord. 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 I'm restoring your glory in double. Thank you, my Father. Are you agreeing with what we are saying now? Because everything is possible now. Everything. He asked me, he says, speak to them and worship me and drop the word, and I will walk the rest. And I'm still speaking to you. You better begin to believe. You better begin to agree. Because every day may not be your day. But there is a day that has been assigned for you. And I sense that today is a day that has been assigned for your destiny. There are no people who believe it. I can't see a sign that you believe that. I can't see a sign around you that you believe that. Every day may not be your day. But today is your day. Today is your day. I just hear him saying, he says, say three more things to them. And I'm saying three more things to you. Three more things. Thank you, my Father. Thank you, my Father. Father, that person that is due for an operation, and you say, I should say to the person that you are healing the person now. I paralyze every hand troubling your destiny in the name of Jesus Christ. Whoever has gotten a certificate for your death, Haman got a certificate that all the Jews should be eliminated. Baruza Tali Baruza. Whosoever has gotten a certificate for your death, by the authority that cannot fail, I terminate them in the name of Jesus Christ. Whoever stretched evil hand towards this church, I build my church and the gates of hell shall not prevail. Every evil hand stretched towards us, I return you with paralysis in the name of Jesus Christ. From this day forward, every soul that is represented here, joy unlimited in the name of Jesus Christ. You are great, yes you are. Holy Lord. Thank you, my Father. You walk upon the sea. You raise the dead. I can hear somebody help me say it. Say it better. Glory in majesty. Mighty one. Lift up your hands and say, everything written about you is great. Everybody lift up your hands and say,
you are great, yes you are. Holy Lord,
you walk upon the sea, you raise it.
You walk upon the sea,
and you raise the dead.
Oh, you reign.
You reign in majesty.
Say you are great. Say you are great.
You are great.
Everybody say
you are great.
You are great.
You are great.
Oh, yes,
you are great.
You are great. Worship you today, little world of praise,
as we do the Lord's prayer,
we bless your name,
Lord.
I can hear somebody say,
we praise the Lord's prayer,
everything,
yeah.
prophesy by the anointing. I speak by the anointing. Malabosh, Shandalabarabosh. To that man, to that woman, standing before the altar of the Almighty God, wherever men have ridiculed you, wherever men has brought shame upon you, I hear him say, say to them, there is a new glory coming for you. Jump up if you want to say your amen and shout. I decree for the last time now, for those who will believe, and I say, by the authority that cannot fail, this is a Sunday of power. This is a Sunday of release. This is a Sunday of testimony. This is a Sunday of... Now, somebody take this one. Take this one as you go. Take this one as you go. Can I say something to you? There was a key that opened the first half of the year. There is a key that must open the second half of the year. It's only those who have the key that have access to the blessing of the second half of the year. I come by the anointing of God because I've been anointed. The keys that opened the second half of the year that delivered the miracle to the hand of humanity. If your amen are confirmed, can be the loudest. I deliver the keys into your heart. Say to the north, say to the south, say to the west, I claim the key. Say, I claim the key. Say to the south, say to the west, say to the north, I claim the key that opened the second half of the year. Thank you, my Father. I give you praise. Men are taking the key. Men are taking the key. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you for men are taking the key. Hallelujah to the King of Glory. Hallelujah to the King of Glory. Thank you, Lord. You permit me, my mission sermon is going to be prophetic. I discovered something, friends. Wait first, before you sit down. You may choose not to sit down. Nobody will arrest you. I discovered something that when men hear about mission, fear comes upon them as if God is going to send them to die. Maybe one of the reasons why men are not yielding to this call is some of the fear and the sad story they have had. And I don't want to doubt it, and you know that life itself is risk. Anybody asked me, as the Holy Ghost was talking to me, that if men die for things that will not profit them, why would men better ready to die 10 times? Times for things that will profit them. Somebody will put bomb on his body and go and die for a mission that will lead him to hell. And yet, men cannot put the bomb of the Holy Ghost in their body. The scripture as a bomb, loaded yourself with a grenade of heaven and go somewhere to explode. But I began to talk to God yesterday. He said, tell them that the theme is the king's call. He said, tell them the benefit of the king's call. Excuse sir, there is a benefit when the king calls and you obey. There's a benefit. There's a benefit. And I will show you a few things. Even though the king's call is urgent, is demanding, is risky, is sudden, he doesn't call for a long time. He calls suddenly. I'll be giving you my scriptures. You go and read it at home. Because I'm not having all the time. The test, of course. 2 Samuel 23, 30 to 17. I didn't say sit down yet, though. Did I say so? Judges 5, 18. But let me tell you a few things. Let me tell you a few things. Friends, look at me. The king told me yesterday that there are two categories of people that he's looking for, and that it entails them risking their lives. The ones that we go and those that we support, both involve risk. Those who we go must be ready to give all it takes for the works of the king. Those who will give must be ready to risk their finance for the mission of the king. But the king says, I shall announce to you that there is a reward. Tell somebody, say, there is a reward. I will soon ask you to sit down. Two more minutes. He called Moses. Very urgent call. I discovered that all these people that he called, it was urgent. Suddenly, he will just call you. And you must respond, sir, there is no excuse when the king is calling. Many of you have excuses, but once the king is calling, Moses, Exodus chapter 3, read the whole. Because the call of the king is a call to liberate humanity. And I announced to you that Omega 2 is the main call of the king. If you have not been part of Omega 2, you are still out of the call of the king. His people have been in captivity for about 400 years. There are men that are in captivity here and there. Those who are carry bomb, they are in captivity. Those who are terrorists, they are in captivity. And the king needs another Moses to face the Pharaoh that trained him. It was a risky call because it was in the house of Pharaoh that Moses was trained. Moses knew the power of Pharaoh, the army of Pharaoh, how terrible Pharaoh was, how strong Pharaoh was. Yes, there was a call from the king. Go and tell Pharaoh, I am that I am. There's somebody in this place that is going to tell the world that the I am that I am is alive. Is the person in the house here now? It's risky. It's dangerous. It's not easy. And unfortunately, the king have not told Moses for over a year. He just told him that moment and you must move. But let me tell you, sir, because I'm going to pray now. Once it's the king that is calling and you are obeying the king, he made you Lord over the people you want to go and talk to. Hey, they didn't get it. Moses was full of fear. He said, excuse, sir, I can't go. There is a fear of Pharaoh in me. And the king said to Moses, what I will do that will surprise you? I will make you king, Lord God, over Pharaoh. Not just king, God. You will be in charge of Pharaoh. By the time you will be speaking, Pharaoh will have no choice. Do you know what it means? The man you dread so much, you are the same man, you are facing the same man, and he can't do anything about you. There are men and women that are going to obey the call of the king, either by their finance or by giving their body, that what you fear most will begin to fear you. Now, if you want to sit down, you are free. If you want to stand up, you are free. Hallelujah. You are free to stand, you are free to sit, you are free to do anything. When you obey the call of the king, however dangerous or risky it may be, the power of the king will back you up. They are not hearing me now. Because I know you are afraid. But the power of the king will back you up. That no man will be able to stand before you. How many of you in this house want to move with the assurance that the King of Kings is backing you up? Until you have an assignment for you, he's not committed unto you. It is the assignment you carry out for the king that earns you the commitment of the king, that he will say, I will be with you. Listen to me. The people you call different names that carry bomb, somebody used their hard-earned money to sponsor them. Can I say to you, it may cost you selling your house for the king. It's dangerous and risky. But if that's what the king wants from you. By the way, we are all expected to go. But in case we cannot go, the king said, I want to take what is painful for you. If you can't go, those who are going, they are going to go painfully with risk. Then you also risk something for me. How many of you will risk something for the king today? Can I see you waving your hand like this? God bless you. And Moses went before Pharaoh, and you know the story, that by the time Moses got to Pharaoh, Pharaoh can't do him anything. He came back bringing glory to the Almighty God. In 2 Samuel 23, verses 13 to 17, David screamed, "Oh, that someone may give me water to drink from the well of Bethlehem. Can somebody give me water to drink? I'm thirsty. And I want to drink water where the enemies are." Three men. Those are the suicide bombers. Spiritual suicide bomber. "Something bothers me, sir. These are the Philistines. They are ready to attack. The whole Israel faced Philistine. There was problem." And yet three men who heard the king's call, because it was urgent and was risky, they made up their mind to risk their life, and they broke through the rank of the Philistine to draw water for the king. And listen to me, what I saw was, as they were going, the spirit of the king was following them. The battle that the whole Israel find difficult to win, three men won the battle because the power of the king was upon them. Listen to me. As many as we hear the call of the king is going to deposit extraordinary power upon you, that you will break through ranks. In nations, you are going to be breaking through ranks. In wherever you are going to be breaking through ranks. They brought the water, and the king took the water. He said, "This is the blood of some people. I don't want to drink the water." He poured it as a sacrifice unto the Lord. Listen to me. We will not stop to complain until we are ready to do something. The problem of us, of Christianity, is that we complain. I read like that brother said. I'm tired of reading. Somebody want to Islamize. Somebody want to. Let me ask you a question. Whom did Jesus say, "Behold, I give power and authority to"? They or you? Who can change things in the spiritual realm? They or we? So what is our problem? We are too busy with complaining, not ready to do anything. Until you move, the king will not move. How many of us are ready to move this season so that the king can back us up? I speak to you by the authority that cannot fail. Every power that is keeping you in fear, I banish it in the name of Jesus Christ. The king is calling you. Tell somebody, the king is calling you. Say, it's urgent. Say, it's risky. And no excuse. No excuse. I saw the call of the king in different dimensions. Don't worry, when the senior pastor comes to preach the sermon, he will tell you the teacher's perspective. This is an evangelistic perspective. So you will get it. But be getting my own. Nehemiah heard a message about the king, that the wall of Jerusalem has been broken down, and then the enemy can penetrate and attack God's people. Omega 2 Project knew that the world is in problem. So many walls of nations are broken down by religions and terrorism. And yet, Nehemiah was a slave in another land. Nehemiah chapter 1, Nehemiah chapter 2. He made up his mind that this call is a risky call, but I will obey it. I'm telling you the dimension I know. That those who obey this call with sincerity, either by your substance or by your life, the king is there for you. Are you getting what I am saying now? God will not protect what he does not send. And Nehemiah was serving the king. I'm soon going to pray with you. He said, "Cupbearer, give him the tea or wine to drink." And at that time, friends, listen to me. No man is permitted to ask the king for anything. According to the law of that land, you will die if you do. And Nehemiah needed something from the king. As Nehemiah went to serve the wine, his countenance dropped, which is also risky. You shouldn't serve a king with a sad countenance. You are supposed to serve the king very happy because his friends are there. You are bringing a wine to the king, you are frowning your face, you are looking down. But because the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords was involved, the king did not see it that way. Rather, what Nehemiah cannot ask the king asked him. What do you want me to do for you? Why are you sad? What do you want me to do? Somebody is hearing me. By the time you answer this call, either with your substance or whatever, where you cannot ask, where you are not qualified to receive, the king will receive from you there. Say it louder if you want to say it. And everything that was needed for the journey, the king gave it to him, a slave. And then Sanballat and Tobias could not stop him. They came. Listen to me. Omega 2. Every Sanballat and Tobias that want to stand against Omega 2, they shall fall on the order of the first Sanballat and Tobias in the name of Jesus Christ. No man will be able to stand before you if you answer this call. Stop being afraid. Last one before I pray for you. Esther heard that the Jews had been signed to death. There was a signature. A certificate was obtained. Look at it. Tell your neighbor, say, excuse me. Say that to your neighbor, say, excuse me. Now look at me, Sven. Does it not bother you that people spend their money to sponsor evil things? Haman paid so much into the treasury just for God's people to die. Malabo Shandalia. Believers are here. And Omega 2 is sovereign. Needed money. Needed sponsor for liberation of soul. And you are still sitting comfortably. I'm believing God that as soon as I drop now, you'll be finding your way to see whoever is in charge and say, I am committing this. I can't go, but I'm committing this. My job will not permit me, but I'm committing. It's risky. This is my salary. It's risky. I'm dropping this. Some are saying, I am resigning my work. The king's call is urgent. I heard the king's call. It's risky, but I'm going. Nehemiah's Mordecai has sent for Esther. This is it. Esther said, there's nothing. Well, I don't know what to do. Mordecai said, be careful. If you think you are in comfort, you are not in any comfort. Oh. Because if you don't, God will do it in his own way. So many of you are in comfort. And yet souls are dying. So many of you are in comfort. Omega 2 is complaining. There are missionary about 350 missionary in the world that Omega 2 must pay their salary every month because we can't go there. They are in those risky places. They have loaded themselves with grenades of the word of God. They want to explode the nations. They want to bring people out of the kingdom of hell. If your own Esther feels so comfortable, God will raise help, but you will be a loser. And Esther said, pray for me, and I'm going to go. And Esther went. Because if you take step for the king, the king will take two steps ahead of you. Please note that. Each time you want to take a step for the king is two, three steps ahead of you. He's going before you. By the time Esther got to the king, even though she's not permitted to ask the king says, Esther, what is your request? I want to go and pray with you. Let me show you something, and then we will rise up, and I'll prophesy over your life. Hallelujah. Matthew 25, 31 to 46. Everybody rise up. Everybody rise up. Everybody rise up. Rise up. There is one danger. The danger of not obeying the call of the king. Look at the danger. When the Son of Man shall come in glory, in his glory, and all the holy angels with him, then shall he sit upon this throne of his glory. And before him shall be gathered all nations, and he shall separate them one from another. As a shepherd divided his sheep from the goats. In other words, if you have not taken risk for the king, he will separate you. And he shall set the sheep on his right hand. Those who have given their property when it's painful. Those who heed the call of the king when it was dangerous. And they went, risked their life. 350 all over the world. But the goats, who have the money, who are only enjoying with their family, who hear that somebody has just been beheaded yesterday or a few days ago, who are not consigned. And yet, missionaries are saying, send us, we want to go, but we don't have the means to go. Give us the money, we will go and risk our life. Give us the money, we will go and die for him. Give us the money, we don't cost whatever it will cost us. Those ones will be separated at the left as a goat. Then his kings are saying unto them, come ye blessed of my father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me meat. I was thirsty, and you gave me drink. I was stranger, and you took me in. Read on fast. Let's, naked, and you clothed me. That's what Omega 2 is doing. I was sick, and you visited me. I was in prison, and you came into me. And then this I said unto him, the righteous says, Lord, when saw we be hungry and feed your thirsty, and go on, roll it on, I don't have the time. When you saw thee a stranger and took thee or naked and clothed thee, roll it. Or when saw thee sick, roll it. And then the king will say unto them, when Omega 2 project was on, you have done. As much as you have done it in Omega 2 project, you have done it to me. Roll it. Roll it now. Roll it to the other one. Okay. Now, these are the other people he was talking about. Those who had the sermon today. Those who have been hearing the sermon, that will hear the sermon throughout this month. I said, please roll it back. Let me get it for them. Roll it back to where I stopped. Roll it back, roll it back, roll it back, roll it back. Go back. Then shall he say unto them on the left hand, who were comfortable with their offices, with their best car, in their best house, who had a call that people are dying, who had the call that if somebody can tell these people, they may not probably carry bomb. It is the information they know they are acting on. If they hear a better information, they may not carry the bomb. He said, depart from me, you cause unto everlasting fire. Prepare for the devil and his angel. And they said, I was hungry and you gave me no meat. I was thirsty. Roll it. Roll it. Keep on it. Roll it. Use it. Use it. Roll it. Then shall they say unto him, Master, we saw you hungry and all this thing that we did not do. Roll it. And he said, since you refuse to heed the key of Omega 2 project, you have not done it to me. Because I set up Omega 2 project as my voice to the nations, as my hand to the nation, as my vehicle to send nation, people to the nations, to bring them out of darkness, like I sent Moses to bring people out of captivity. And Omega 2, people, men said they wanted to go. And you were there and they said there was no money. They said we can't pay the salary like before. And you were there eating comfortably. And then some people were there in Pakistan, in Afghanistan. The last time I had a senior pastor went to either Pakistan or one of those people places, I was afraid. I said, God, what's this man looking for? God have mercy. They were there risking their life, and you are here waking up. They can't sleep the way you sleep. They cannot wake up the way you wake up, brothers. They wake up in fear. They sleep in danger. They carry their Bible in danger, going to meet somebody who can stab them to death. And you are here. And we say, let's feed them. You can't feed them. You better cry to the altar and ask God for mercy. You better cry to the altar and ask God for mercy. You better cry to the altar and say, God, I give down my car, let them sell it, let those people eat. I rather hungry than for them to hungry. Now this is what I'm giving. Lord, I'm giving my life. Bow down your head, everybody. Close your eyes. Close your eyes and talk to God. What will you have me to do in this matter? This is a serious matter. I don't want to be say, depart. I don't want to hear the voice. Depart from me. The voice of the king is urgent, risky, but no excuse. Every excuse cannot be taken by the king. Because the king risked his life just for you to get your salvation. As you bow down your head, the Spirit of God wants me to pray for about 10 people. They are here. I don't know where they are seated. But they need to surrender their life to the king. That is another strange, a very powerful call. The king wants them to surrender their life now. You are here, you are hearing me, you have been going to church. You may even be a worker in the church, but you have not given your life completely to the king. You have not surrendered to the king. You are still living in your sin. The king is very angry with you, but there is mercy in the house this morning. The king said, call them and pray for them. I will have mercy on them. If you are one of those people who want to surrender your life to Jesus, I know you go to church. I know you even walk. He said, as you lay my hands on you, that mercy will speak for you. Wherever you may be, and you want to put the devil to shame, I said, Satan, shame unto you. Lift up your right hand above your head, wherever you are standing. Thank you. Lift it up. Thank you. I see hands now. Lift it up. Anywhere you are. Whether you are in this side, lift up your hands. Yes. I see some hands by my left hand side. Yes. Yes. By my left hand, those coming for the first time, wherever you have been running there, let me lay hands on you. Stand up and be walking to the altar. Thank you. Those of you in the congregation, come. Those of you by this side, come. Those of you from that side, come. Please come from where I am. Kneel down before the king. Just kneel down on the altar. Thank you for coming. 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 God bless you, my brother. Sister, thank you for coming. God bless you. This is a call from the king. This is a call from the king. This is a call from the king. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, sister. Anybody yet? Thank you. Where are you? Don't sit down there. Are you in the congregation? Are you in the left hand side? Wherever are you, in the gallery? Come down. Come down. The king is waiting for you. There is no excuse to the call of the king. There is no excuse to the call of the king. Where are you? I have 1 minute to leave this place. Where are you? Quickly come. I'll be talking to the king. Ask for mercy. Ask for mercy, brother. There are 5 people that are still standing there. 5 of you. The king say you should come now before it's too late. I will be waiting for you. I have 1 minute. If you are one of those 5 people, can you come now? Come and surrender your life to Jesus. Come. I'm waiting for you. There are 5 in number and I'm waiting for them. I know you go to church. I know you bear a Christian name, but you are still living in sin and the king is not happy with you. Are you one of those people? Can you come now? Can you come now? Thank you, brother. Remaining 4 people. Can you come now? 4 of you are still there. I hear him. I'm not saying what I hear from man. I hear him. If you are coming, come fast. Thank you. Thank you. Don't sing yet. Thank you. Remaining 2 people. Where are they? Where are they? Move from wherever you are. If you are in the gallery, walk down. Walk down. Remaining 1 person. Walk down fast. The king is waiting for you. Don't let this hour pass you by. It's a dangerous hour. This is dangerous. Thank you for coming. Kneel down before the king. It's dangerous to disobey the voice of a king. Thank you, Father. Those of you at the altar, say, Lord Jesus, I've heard your voice and I have come to surrender my life unto you. Come into my life, forgive me my sins, write my name in the book of life, and I will serve you all the days of my life. Amen. Father, I pray for these ones that you have mercy on them. Let their names be written in the book of life. Let their sins be forgiven. Let their transgression be cleansed. Please let me lay hands on those ones there. Forgive them, Lord. We bring them to you. We initiate them to you, to your love, to your power. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Your sins are forgiven. Your sins are forgiven. Your sins are forgiven. Your sins are forgiven. Please stand up. Stand up. Please follow. This is my pastor. Please just follow like this for just a few minutes. Thank you. Just follow like this. Just follow like this. Church, rise up on your feet. I'm dropping the microphone now. Church, rise up on your feet. I'm dropping the microphone now. Church, rise up on your feet. I'm dropping the microphone now. Everybody hear me? There are 2 things I want to say, and as I drop the microphone. Number 1, if you're part of the people that came out on Saturday, Tuesday is the last day, and obey God. Number 2, if the Holy Spirit have spoken to you anything about this message of today, and you want to respond to him in any way, can you in under 1 minute come to this altar and just kneel down for 1 minute and then
you can go back.
You are not talking to any human being, but it is between you and God. Can you just walk down to this altar? Thank you. If you are coming, come fast. Come fast. We don't have all the time. Just walk down to the altar, kneel down, and talk to God. Thank you. Come fast. My time is up. Come, kneel down before this altar. Kneel down before this altar. And just settle that thing that he has spoken to you. You heard him say something to you. Maybe he's asking you to go. Maybe he's asking you to give. Those are two people, two categories. Those who will go and those who will give. Which one do you want to be? I want to go. I want to give. Omega 2 is asking you, give. Omega 2 is saying, give, you won't regret it. Omega 2 is saying, go, you won't regret it. Omega 2 is saying, go, we will back you up. Brethren, let's come and settle with God and say, Lord, help me. I want to go. Lord, help me. I want to give. Please, one more minute. Please, be fast. Lord, help me. I want to give. Lord, help me. I want to go. How will you feel if you hear that somebody has been beheaded again? Do you feel happy? Do you feel happy that innocent girls, bombs are planted in their body? And you hear the news, you say, after all, it's not my family. On the last day, he will say to some of them, go to the left. Some of them, go to the right. One more minute. One more minute. As I hand over to the senior pastor to pray for this one. Are you coming, brother? I know you are a partner to Omega 2. Please, if you have not been faithful, let's renew our faithfulness. These stories are sad. These stories are painful. The king is calling for men and women. Who shall I send? Who shall go for me? It's risky. The call is risky. I need to drink water. Yes, the Philistines are there. Who will give me water to drink? That's what the king is saying. Who will break through the ranks of the enemy and give me water to drink?
Brethren that are here, please rise to your feet. Thank you. I don't know the commitment you are making, but thank you for making this commitment. And many are sitting down. I don't know why they are sitting down. I don't know why you are sitting. This is a very serious moment. Jesus shed his blood for you. For a covenant to be implementable, there's an exchange of blood. Jesus has shed his own blood. Where is yours? Many of us want to enjoy the covenant of Jesus. Oh, it's a covenant keeping God. Yes, he is. Gather unto me, he says, all my children who have established a covenant with me by sacrifice. You must cut your own covenant with Jesus. If you didn't, then no covenant exists for you. Jesus shed his blood at 7 points of his body, and today he's asking you for yours. Where is your own blood? Don't forget, there must be an exchange of blood. He's asking you for your blood. And these are the only ones who today want to cut a covenant with Jesus. I'm surprised. And frankly, I must be honest with you, I'm deeply saddened by that. that this has just, the rest of you are standing there. I don't know what you are standing there doing. I don't know what you are standing there doing. He's asking you to lay your blood on this altar. He has shed his own for you at Calvary. And he's asking for your own blood. Those three men, those three valiant men of David, they broke through the ranks of the Philistines. Of course, when they brought back the water, David knew that what he had in his hand was not water. It was the blood of those men. David was just a man. The God of heaven, your creator, your maker, is asking for your own blood. Where is your own blood? I want us to bow our heads. We should bow our heads in repentance, asking him for mercy. Because you couldn't hear a word as you have, that has been shared with us, and you see seared up your heart. And you are making no decisions. And these are the only ones who are saying one way or the other, we are ready to do something about this matter. Can I give you the bad news? Everybody in this building will make a decision today. Everybody. By force, by fire. Whether you like it or not, because in that he died for all. That all who now live should not live to themselves, but should live unto him who died and gave his life for them. So I don't know what your decision is going to be, but you must make a decision. Why don't you just bow your head wherever you are and say something to your maker? Offer your own blood on this altar. Offer your own blood on this altar. That Lord, in exchange for your blood, I offer mine. For this covenant to be established. I offer my blood. We may take 2 more minutes later than we should close. That's okay. Our closing time is not cast in stone. But I must extract blood for Jesus in this meeting today. He said he will let his prisoners go out of the hole where there is no water by the covenant. There's a covenant relationship between you and him, and he needs to have your blood. You want to shed your own blood in exchange for his today, just so he can establish a covenant with you. Lift up your 2 hands to heaven. I'm ready, Lord. This is my blood. I offer it now. If you are raising those 2 hands, why don't you raise them up well? It's not unto me, it's unto him. All of us in this building today must make a decision to exchange our blood, to lay our lives on the line. Those poorly informed fellows who blow up themselves in airplanes for 72 virgins that do not exist, they do it for a useless cause. We have a noble cause. We have a noble cause to lay our lives down for. In this meeting this morning, I'm raising terrorists. Terrorists for Jesus. Those who will lay their lives down and say, my life for theirs. Raise those hands. I want to pray for you. I just don't want to make it those ones who are in front here. All of us in this building, lift up your hands. Unless Jesus did not die for you. If he died for you, then you owe him your blood. Your blood must be available to him. And he doesn't need to beg for that. My Father, I want to thank you for this meeting. I have spoken to them the truth that you have showed us through your word. That if one died, then we're all dead. That those who now live should not live unto themselves, but everyone should now live unto him who died and gave his life for them. Lord, look at your children. They are holding up their blood. The life of a being is in his blood. This is their lives. They are holding up to you, oh God. Receive their blood from them in exchange for yours. Lord, these are the ones you said I should gather unto you. All them, your children, who have established a covenant with you by sacrifice. This is the sacrifice of their blood. Blood, please take it from their hands. Establish a covenant with them. Each one of them in particular. In whichever way your Holy Spirit will move in their hearts, move in their spirits, move in their lives for your sake and for the sake of your gospel. Father, we are thankful for the privilege to lay down our lives for you. We do it without holding back. And we say, blessed be your name, our Father. Thank you, Jehovah. Jesus, wonderful name, we have prayed. If you had, I don't want any clap, please. If you wanted to do something for this cause, it's a noble cause, it's the noblest cause. Just call any of the ushers, take a slip from them, write whatever your commitment is. If it's just to pray, if it's to give, if it's to go, just collect a sheet of paper from the ushers and the Lord will bless you. Those of you in front, let's know your commitment you are making. Write your full details and the Lord will accept your sacrifice. Amen.